Yeah. Hello, everybody around the world on RonnieMilsap.com. And this is Ronnie. This is quite an event. This is actually my first podcast. And we're going to start trying to do these if I can become proficient at doing them. RonnieMilsap.com. Certainly want to thank Mia Bain, who is the webmaster. You're extraordinary, always the best. And she has moved to Florida now. We've determined that actually you can run a business from anywhere in the world. You can certainly run a website from anywhere in the world. Okay, let's get on with our first record here. This is my first number one record, and recorded January the 8th, 1974. Pure love.
Pure love. Baby, it's pure love. Milk and honey and Captain Crunch and you in the morning. Pure love. Baby, it's pure love. 99 and 44, 100% pure love. I wake up with sunshine. Laying beside me, and bluebirds singing right outside my window. Soft, warm kisses say good morning. Then I get breakfast in bed. You know you make me so happy.
I mentioned, recorded on January the 8th, 1974. A song is written by Eddie Rabbit. And originally, Eddie had 7 verses on this thing, and I was working with Tom Collins. He and I were producing the records for RCA. We had had a couple of top 10 records, but didn't have the first number one until 1974. Pure love, 7 verses. I said, let's do the chorus and do the first verse and do the chorus and modulate up to A natural and do the chorus again. It's a nice short radio record. So it was great. And to have your first number one record, let me say, it's always a big thrill. We're on podcast number 1, running this on RonnieMilsap.com. I hope you folks are enjoying this. You can kind of let us know how you feel about these podcasts, maybe what you'd like to hear. Right now, we actually played the track as a theme song, but I get a lot of requests because there's a big song called "In the Still of the Night," written by Freddie Paris from the Five Satins. The record was popular in the 50s. So, you know, there were some people involved in writing this song, and it was pitched to the Oak Ridge Boys and to Alabama because I thought it was a group song. And eventually I decided to record it myself, and it turned up to be a huge record, 1985 for me. So let's play a little bit of Lost in the 50s tonight, and we'll talk to you more about it as we go along here. on podcast number one on RonnieMilsap.com.
Close your eyes, baby, follow my heart, call on the memories here in the dark. We'll let the magic take us away, back to the feelings we shared when they played in the still. Precious hours we know can't survive, but love's all that matters while the past is alive. Now and for always, till time disappears, we'll hold each other whenever we in the still.
Millsap with Lost in the 50s Tonight. And this is Ronnie on RonnieMilsap.com. And with this is podcast number one for me. And we're trying this out to see if folks are interested in this. Doing a podcast ever so often here. But this is podcast number one, Lost in the 50s Tonight. And that last high C, I actually played the mix for my wife, Joycey, who has tremendous influence in the records we put out. And she said, well, the ending is pretty cool, but it doesn't really go anywhere. I wish you could put a high note on there somehow. And I said, well, I can't get back in the studio. It was my studio that I had down on Music Row for 18 years called Ground Star Laboratory. And I said, I can't get in there because there's clients in there tomorrow. And she said, well, you need that high, you need some high note on the end of it. So I was going to have to catch the bus at midnight and ride somewhere. So I called my producer, Rob Galbraith, and I said, I need to be in the studio at 8:30 in the morning because, you know, this, I got to put this high note at the end of Lost in the 50s. And so I had to lease a Learjet to get to the next date. And, you know, times were different. Fuel was a lot cheaper back then. And the cost of leasing an airplane was a lot cheaper as well. So anyway, it cost me $5,000 to get to the next date with the Learjet. So I call that high C on the end of Lost in the 50s tonight my $5,000 note. It sure was the right thing to do. Let's move along to my latest CD project, which is a two CD set called Then Sings My Soul. It's my first gospel project. And the fans have been talking about a gospel project for years. And we finally got around to doing one. EMI Christian approached my manager and asked, would I be interested in doing this? And we all came up with a song selection, a song list that we were all comfortable with. And it has a lot of traditional songs on it that I sing in my own style. The first single that's off this album is a brand new song. It's called Up to Zion. Yes, sir. Up.
Oh, I'm gonna move up,
yeah,
up to Zion, because this world is not my home. Oh, one day I'm gonna fly way over to the other side. I know I'll get to see the Lord.
Just like Daniel,
he was thrown right into the lion's den. I have faith and I'm gonna trust in him. Oh no, like the Hebrew boys, tried in the fire, been baptized. I don't feel no waste time. Move up, up to Zion, because this world is not our home. You want to go, you better get ready. He's coming back again like a thief in the night. You better get ready, you better get right. Move up, up to Zion, because this world
Hallelujah. Yes, sir. Up to Zion, brand new off the new CD, two CD set for EMI Christian, my first gospel project. And that song is called Up to Zion, written by Noreen Creighton out of New York, and a great new song. And this two-CD set is available anywhere you find CDs nowadays. They certainly sell them at Walmart, Best Buys. They sell them, of course, on Amazon.com. In fact, you can even go to iTunes and download one particular song that you'd want off this package if you wanted to do it that way. Digital downloads, I guess that's the way of today. But it's a two-CD set, 24 songs, and my first gospel project, and I'm very proud of it, and it's doing real well. We're playing Up to Zion in the shows, and you can see all the dates that we play and that we're putting up on the website, and we look forward to seeing you at the shows. If you can make the show as a cyber fan, be sure to come up and talk to Mr. Jamie Brantley. He's my road manager, and he's the guy that also plays guitar in the band. He's the band leader as well. And if, he's a man of multi-talents, that man is. And we're going to step back in time a long way and do a song. And actually, I had to record this song twice. I did it the first time in 1975 in Studio A of RCA. And we recorded it, and for some reason, the engineers cut it to tape, and it was too hot. The level was too much level to tape, so it was distorted. And the head of RCA, Jerry Brantley, said, "Millsap, you got to go back in and record it again." So we couldn't find a place to record it. We couldn't get back in Studio A for like 3 months, and Brantley said, "Go over to Studio C." And I remember when we cut this in Studio C, I was sitting with the drummer. I could reach over and touch him. He was to my right, and Bobby Wood, the piano player, was on my left, and I was playing Wurlitzer on this. And Steve Gibson played lead guitar on this. He's now the musical director of the Grand Ole Opry. And the great John Huey played steel on this song, and we're going to lay it on you right now, and it's called Daydreams About Night Things. There we go, from 1975 on RonnieMilsap.com.
I'm having daydreams about night things in the middle of the afternoon, and while my hands make a living, my mind's home loving you. Daydreams about night things in the middle of the afternoon, and every night you make my daydreams come true. Well, all day long while I'm working in town, time slows down to a crawl. When I'm not thinking about you, I'm checking the clock on the wall. Then it's goodbye factory and hello. Smile across my face, 'cause I'm back in the arms of your sweet love, where my thoughts have been all day. I'm having daydreams about night things in the middle of the afternoon, and while my hands make a living, my mind's home loving you. I'm having daydreams about night things daydreams.
make my daydreams come true.
Yeah, Daydreams About Night Things from 1975, the summer of 1975. And this is Ronnie Milsap on ronniemilsap.com with podcast number one. Daydreams About Night Things was written by John Schwears, who's written so many songs for me, especially in my early country career. I wrote many, many songs, but I remember being down there the day that he came up with Daydreams About Night Things. He was reading an article in some magazine, and Olivia Newton-John had mentioned something about, looking for songs and talking about something about her life and something about having daydreams about night things. And Schwears jumped up and said, "I'm going to write that song." And he did. About 15 minutes, he had this song called Daydreams About Night Things. And as I told you, we had to record it twice in order to finally get it to tape, a recording to 16-track analog tape back in those days. And that was a huge hit record. I remember at the time, it was the biggest selling hit record I'd had. Pure Love did real well as the first number one, but we got into a string of number ones. But by the time Daydreams About Night Things happened, that turned out to be the biggest record at that point in my career. I remember playing that at a show down in just outside of Beaumont at a club called the Real Palm Isle. And it was a really great country nightclub. And I remember I said, I'm going to play this brand new song for you. We just recorded it, and it's going to be coming out next Tuesday. And see what you think about it. And I played Daydreams About Night Things with my band. And the audience loved it so much, they requested it 5 more times on the show. And I kind of thought right then, well, this thing really does seem to have the right feel with the people. And what are we going to next, Donnie? Oh, yeah. Okay, let's do that. I did a special album for RCA back in 2006. And we had a couple of singles off of it. But the song I really like most is actually the title song. The title song is called My Life. We're going to play it for you right now. Podcast number one on ronniemilsap.com.
I want to know if I walked down a certain road, it was my choice. And I want to know if I had something to say, I raised my voice. I don't want to wake up a little too late and say I could have done this or I should have done that. When I close my eyes at night, I want to know I'm doing the best I can. When I'm sitting there in my rocking chair, make my own. Don't want my epitaph to read, wish they could have known me. I don't want that carved in stone. I want to leave this place with a smile on my face, knowing what's in my heart didn't just stay in my heart. And whatever heaven gave me, I wanna know I gave it all back. When I'm sitting there in my rocking chair looking at my life, I hope to God I would have done something good with my life. At the end of the day,
that song is called My Life, and that's the title song from the album called My Life for RCA. That came out back in 2006. And focusing one more time before we get out of here, this is podcast number one. Give us some feedback. What do you think about this kind of stuff? You like it? You hate it? Whatever. I'm getting through just a little bit of a head cold right now today. Good I don't have to sing tonight. But I'm going out to sing this weekend, and I'm going to have fun with the band. So we're going to play something again from the Then Sings My Soul CD. And this was a secular hit many, many years ago. I just always thought it would work as a gospel song. And it does. It works really well. It's called Stand By Me, and I think you'll recognize it. Yes, sir. On RonnieMilsap.com, podcast number one.
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see, no, I won't be afraid. Oh, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me. Oh, sweet Jesus, stand by me. Upon should tumble and fall, and the mountain should crumble to the sea, I won't cry. I won't cry. No, I won't shed a tear. Just as long as you stand by me. trouble, stand by me, stand by me. Oh, sweet Jesus, stand by me, please stand by me. Oh, when I need a friend, won't you stand?
Yeah, Stand By Me, that's out of Then Sings My Soul, my latest two CD set, which is my first gospel project on EMI Christian. You can buy that anywhere you can purchase CDs. And by the clock on the wall, it looks like we're through with podcast number one on RonnieMilsap.com. Let us know how you feel about these podcasts. And until next time, this is Ronnie Milsap. God bless you.